The statement I made about the brakes of my RTR 200 in the review became more evident to me after using the FZ25 over 2 months and finally when I rode the race-spec RTR 200 on the track. I'm not stating here that the brakes on the RTR 200 are bad, but there are better brakes out there. This video is a kind of failed attempt, but the ideology behind it is not. So let's begin. The plan here to improve the braking performance on my RTR 200 is really simple and I am planning to achieve it in two ways. Number one is by the use of steel braided lines, where it helps in providing better brake force by reducing the expansion of brake lines when the lever is pressed. Rubber being more elastic and flexible expands and thus reduces the brake force coming from the master cylinder to the caliper. Point number 2 here is by upgrading the brake fluid. I really wanted to upgrade to a racing brake fluid from a very long time now, of course which is not .5 and can sustain high temperatures without causing any brake fade even when we brake hard on highways or on a continuous downhill ride. Apart from the Liqui Moly racing brake fluid, I got the steel braided brake lines from Pulsar 220 and in case of requirement, I also got extra washers and banjo bolts. At first, we have to remove the brake line from the mounting points. First one is on the fork and you will need a 8mm spanner or a socket to set it free. Next, we have to move under the triple tree and I had to struggle a lot to get this clear view on the camera. The same 8mm spanner or socket will do the job here. At this point, the brake line is in contact between the top master cylinder and the bottom caliper. It's always suggested to open the caliper bolt first, as it will be easy to drain the brake fluid from down here. You will need a 14mm spanner or a socket for that. Brake fluid is corrosive on painted surface, so avoid spilling it and keep it away from pets and children. A tip here is to loose the top master cylinder bolt by a turn or two and let the remaining brake fluid in the system to drain away. Avoid pressing the brake lever at this point. Once the top master cylinder bolt is out, it's time to replace the rubber brake hose with the steel braided one. Just to demonstrate the assembly, the end of the brake line hose is sandwiched in between two washers from where the banjo bolt passes. Just after installing the steel braided brake line on the top master cylinder, I realized failure was stepping in this project. A new Pulsar 220's brake hose is about an inch short than the standard brake line on the RTR 200, and this is where I had to pay for the negligence. The steel braided brake line from Pulsar 220 failed to reach the caliper and shattered all my immediate hopes along with the time and money I spent on this project. So I had to install back the rubber brake line and my last hope was now on the race brake fluid. So if you go online and search, you will find a lot of good stuff about the Liqui Moly race brake fluid and to be frank, I got this one because it is one of the most affordable race brake fluid available in the market. With dry boiling point around 320 degrees Celsius, which is way above than the standard .4 brake fluid's boiling point of 230 degrees Celsius. I did make a detailed video covering each and every aspect of brake bleeding, link for which can be found in this video description. Now coming back to the performance of the race brake fluid, surprisingly it did make a difference even with the rubber brake hose. Now I can try to justify this better braking to myself with two reasons. One being the brake oil is really good in performance and the lubricating additives in this race brake fluid has made the braking better. Second reason can be my old brake oil which was 2 years old and being hygroscopic, it might have absorbed moisture over time, which in turn brought down its performance. So relatively, the new race brake fluid felt a lot better in performance. So with all of this, I can try to end this video on a happy note. Still, I would say that we all learn from our mistakes and hope you guys got to learn from mine. Do let me know if you liked this video.